Leading us off tonight, the communion wars are heating up as fake Catholic Nancy Pelosi made it clear yesterday she'll make her own decisions about committing sacrilege. Thank you very much. Church Militant's William Mahoney looks at how the Vatican seems to have her back.
The Vatican's recent call for endless dialogue on banning public heretics from the Eucharist set the stage for the U.S. Speaker of the House to dismiss American prelates looking to enforce canon law. In a press conference Thursday, a reporter asked House Speaker and aggressive pro-abort Nancy Pelosi her thoughts on those American prelates who might ban her and her ilk from Holy Communion.
I think I can use my own judgment on that, but I'm pleased with what the Vatican put out on that subject. Did you read that?
That'll be up to the individual priests?
No, it basically says don't be divisive on the subject. Thank you.
Pelosi referred to last week's letter from Cardinal Luis Ladaria of the Congregation of the Doctrine of the Faith. The prelate advised the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops, USCCB, to be generic in establishing guidelines on worthy reception of the Eucharist.
By il Papa sia gesuita o no.
But Ladaria's call for greater ambiguity is a divorce from canonical clarity, Canon 915, and clear instruction from the Vatican already established. In a 2004 letter to the USCCB, the then chief doctrinal watchdog, now Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI, said, "Regarding the grave sin of abortion or euthanasia, when a person's formal cooperation becomes manifest, understood in the case of Catholic politician, as his consistently campaigning and voting for permissive abortion and euthanasia laws, he is not to present himself for Holy Communion until he brings to an end the objective situation of sin. He will otherwise be denied the Eucharist."
Il mese scorso l'Università Cattolica del Sacro Cuore in Italia.
In his own letter to the USCCB, Ladaria dismissed that 2004 correspondence, claiming then Cardinal Ratzinger was only stipulating and the text wasn't intended for publication.
"The raw ugliness of evil is never so apparent in our land than in this horrendous crime of abortion."
Pelosi's Archbishop is Salvatore Cordiglione of San Francisco. In a recent pastoral letter titled, "Before I Formed You in the Womb, I Knew You," Cordiglione wrote, "Those who reject the teaching of the Church on the sanctity of human life and those who do not seek to live in accordance with that teaching should not receive the Eucharist." The prelate discussed the letter on Monday.
I do not have a political motive for doing this. I would rather a pro-abortion politician become a pro-life politician then be replaced by one who is pro-life, because we expand the pool of those who are pro-life in public life. So my purpose is not to sway votes. My purpose is to save souls.
It's unclear if Cordiglione has spoken with Pelosi or denies her communion. William Mahoney, Church Militant Evening News, Detroit.
Church Militant reached out to the San Francisco Archdiocese for clarification. A spokesman responded late this afternoon to Church Militant saying, quote, "We should have more on this soon, potentially tomorrow. I wish I could share more right now, but the Archbishop's schedule has not allowed for that yet. Many blessings. Thank you for your patience."